G'day and welcome back to Buildsum, and this is just a quick video to show you what happens to a truss when you actually put a load in it, what members go into tension and what members go into compression. So taking away all the auxiliary stuff just to clear things up a bit, and we're going to put a load down onto our truss. So when the load pushes down onto the truss, what it actually does, it tends to want to push these walls out and push these apart, which actually wants to bow this bottom cord. So the bottom cord of the truss actually goes into tension because it's trying to be pulled longer. Okay, so this is going to bow, or try to bow that way. So that goes into tension. The top cords, because they're anchored at both ends and this is trying to pull out, or pull up, it's actually going to push the top cords into compression. So they are going to compress. So they'll be under compression load. So then, if this is being pushed down and this is being pushed out, these two web members here are going to go into tension because they're actually being made longer. Okay, and if those two are in tension, then this one here is actually going to be in compression. So this is part of the reason why we don't, or we're not allowed to cut trusses, and why structural engineers actually have to design them, because all these members are in different forces acting on them, and we're not always going to be 100% sure. Also, if we had a cantilevered web, then that web member would be in tension as well. Okay, so there you go. There's the members of a truss in tension and compression.